cooking. And also highly skilled, of course.
I let you cheat.
You can't cheat at drafts.
You would if you could. It's the same thing as the spirit of cheating.
You want your revenge.
Yes, why not? I'm an optimist. I love this game. It's so utterly pointless.
Aren't all games? Isn't that the point of them? Hey, maybe I could do a thesis on that.
You're not going to do a postgraduate, are you?
Yeah, I might. I rather fancy being a student long as possible. Now, what shall I call my thesis?
The utter pointlessness of board games.
I like something a bit more pretentious. How about the lack of meaning, the intrinsic lack of meaning in board games as a therapeutic activity?
That's perfect. No, it sounds a bit American, though.
Maybe I'll do it abruptly, huh?
It was a good clean fight, and I'm glad to have won.
You distracted my attention.
I wish I could.
You can. You do.
And why don't you stay?
I'm not going to make love to you, if that's what you mean.
Why not? And don't you fancy me?
Yes. But I think it's too soon.
You don't think I'm still in love with Felix, do you?
No. But I don't think you're quite over him either. And I don't want to help you prove you are.
That was nasty.
No, it wasn't. But I could stay and we could just sleep.
Could we?
Yeah. I think that's what you really want. Why not? Anyway, I'm quite shy.
Even with me?
Especially with you.
Sometimes I just want someone to hug me so much. I think if I don't, I might die.
Time, do you? God, you're disgusting.
Mrs. What? Has something happened to Mum?
Oh, nothing much. Unless she told the truth for once. That must have shaken her up.
Excuse me, I don't think we should walk into Sally's room like this in the middle of the night.
Oh, just stay out of this. Get out! I'll deal with you later.
Don't leave me. Of course I won't. Look, calm down. What's the matter with you? Where is Steve? Why'd he come bursting in?
Christ, Sally, how could you do it?
Don't shout at her!
Just you mind your own business. This is a family matter.
I want him all to stay.
Why didn't you tell me? I could have done something. I could have helped you.
Look, I saw you. Did you have a row?
Oh, God, how you stick together. Yes, of course we had a bloody row. What do you think we did? Should I congratulate her on helping you murder your baby?
You're alone!
Why, Felix, for God's sake! You know what it's like. How could you? You behave like a tramp and you can't even tell me the truth! 10 years I've loved you and looked after you and you do this terrible thing and you can't even tell me.
Shut up! You're not my father!
I could think of nothing else all the time I was driving down here and then finding you like that.
Well, we're only friends, actually. Not that it matters.
No, you're entitled. It's none of my business. I've no right to speak to you like that or walk into your room.
The thing is, I don't understand why Mum told you. I mean, that was part of it, really. We agreed all along. What on earth made her tell you now?
She didn't. Inga told me. She wanted to make trouble.
Inga? But how does she know?
She found a letter from you in Felix's flat. I'm sorry.
I didn't expect him to be heartbroken or anything. It's just, it's a bit near home, that's all.
Yes, I know. You must have loved him very much.
Yes, I did. Have you talked to him yet?
No. He's away on holiday.
Please, don't be angry with him. It wasn't his fault.
Oh, Sally, why didn't you tell me? Why didn't you come to me when all this happened? We could have worked something out. Didn't you trust me?
Can't we just forget about it? It was a big thing at the time, but it's over. Mum was right. I couldn't have coped. I don't know why I did it, really.
Sally, did you want to have the baby?
Richard, please, I don't want to talk about it anymore.
Can't you see what this means to me? Something as important as this can happen, and you and Helen don't even bother to tell me. Don't I count? Don't I matter?
Of course you do.
Well, can you imagine how I feel? You're the two people I love most in the world, more than my own children, and you just leave me out.
No, we didn't want to upset you, and we knew you wouldn't agree.
And that was all that mattered?
No, of course not, but it was a crisis. We didn't have much time. We had to make a decision.
Oh, it's as if I didn't exist.
No, Richard, you're overreacting. I know it seems awful, but we didn't mean it like that.
Then how?
I don't know. It was Mum and me.
That's exactly what I
meant. No, we weren't rejecting you. It was just, it was like two women sticking together. Look, I'm sorry about what I said last night. You are like a father to me. Much more than Carey ever was. Particularly now I've met him.
Did he know about all this?
Well, Mum had to tell him. I mean, I was going to stay with him. Oh, Richard, please. It doesn't matter now. It's you and Mum I'm worried about. She must be awfully upset. I mean, what did you say to her? Did she know where you are?
I've left her. I couldn't live with her after this.
But she was only trying to do her best for me.
She was trying to get her own way and she succeeded. It's very simple. If she can behave as if I wasn't there, then I won't be.
You can't just walk out on her. Don't you love her anymore?
Oh, Sally, tell me the truth. If Helen had offered to look after the baby, would you have had it?
I told you, I don't want to talk about it.
Or if Felix had offered to help.
Oh, Richard, please, you mustn't blame Felix or Mum. I made a stupid mistake, but it's over.
You still haven't answered my question.
Looking at the young man's sturdy, streamlined body, suntanned and covered in curly black hair, his eyes a dark, murky brown like deep water, Tony could feel the faint stirrings of something he had denied since his youth. The young man reminded him of a bear, furry and unpredictable. Behind the surface charm, the cuddly exterior lurked an unmistakable air of menace. "I'd like to ask you a few questions about the murder," he said. "In that case, I'd better get dressed," the young man said. "I always think better with my clothes on." Tony followed him out of the sauna and into the jacuzzi. "Such a pity about Stephen and Bernard," said the young man, splashing. "They must have overdone their S&M games. I always thought they would. One of these days."
So Tony Blythe is gay, after all this?
Well, why not? Give my readers something to think about. With a bit of luck, I'll go and read all the other books again, just looking for clues.
Which they won't find.
Yes, they will. You can always find something if you look hard enough, especially if it's not there. That's the basis of most religion.
It's a great idea.
I thought so. He said modestly.
You haven't forgotten Tony Blythe had a wife and children at the beginning.
So did Oscar Wilde.
Right. That's silly of me.
Not at all. You're supposed to be playing with every reader.
And he's always been such a philanderer.
Well, you know what they say about Casanova and Don Juan.
I love it.
Ready with your blue pencil?
Only a couple of details.
Christ. It hurts. I never get used to this. That's my baby you're about to mutilate.
Not at all. I'm going to trim its nails. Right. I love the description of his eyes, but are you sure bears are like that colour?
More or less. Match the fur, don't they?
Do you want me to look it up?
I was hoping you'd say that.
Actually, Richard's eyes are rather like that. Deep and dark.
So they are. I wonder where I got it from.
Will you mind?
Probably think twice before he takes another shower with me at the club. I just wanted some animal imagery, and I like the way that bears can be slow and amiable, but at the same time they can be swift and violent. But I can always change it to a wolf. And the eyes could be curiously light brown, almost yellow, and it wouldn't look like Richard at all, but it'd still have the same feeling of danger.
No, I think the bear is more interesting.
Well, we don't have to decide now. I'll just make a note of it. Any more? Is that all?
It's wonderful.
Just for that. I'll do you back.
So why aren't you eating,
Well, I told you I'm on this diet. It's for spirit and enlightenment. As you rise above the demands of the body, you gain insight and awareness. It's all in the colour supplement last week, didn't you say it?
You save all the labels from the tins you're not eating. When you got 4,000,072, you trade them in for a ticket to Kathmandu. He's on a 60s trip. Peace and love, man.
Carl?
No, Mum, sorry.
What?
I'm not going to do that favour you're about to ask me in that special tone of voice.
It's only a little one, just to ring up your father.
You've been doing that for years.
Only this time I can't. Peter?
Don't do it, Pete. There's a catch to it, my son.
Well, tell me the catch and I might do it.
Well, yesterday your father was very cruel. He said he wouldn't see me anymore. So I told him something very bad about the cow, which he done to make him angry. And now I want to know what's happened.
Well, doesn't sound very spiritual to me.
Right on, man.
Please, I have to know. It took a lot of courage to do what I did. It was a big risk.
Oh, Mum, you do keep on, don't you?
Yes, I usually find. I keep long enough people do what I want.
Dad must be the exception, then.
There's still hope until we die. Is it spiritual enough for you?
All right. What do I have to say?
When your father answers, you have just an ordinary chat. If the cow answers, ask for your father. If she says he's out, ask her when he'll be back. Don't let her be vague, just ask for an exact time.
Yeah, okay.
Mum, don't you think if you let up a bit, you might feel better? I mean, all this keeping on at Dad and calling out the cow, well, it doesn't change anything, but it keeps you sort of worked up. It's bad for you.
If you'd been longer on your diet, you would understand more about suffering.
He's not there. She's got no idea when he'll be back. She sounded very odd, sort of spaced out.
They must have had a big role. Perhaps he has even left her. It is wonderful.
I didn't like doing
it. It was very important to me, and I'm very grateful. Now I must go and make myself beautiful.
I mean, surely it's worse for me than for him. I actually have to have the abortion. He just wasn't told about it. And now he wants me to pretend that everything could have been different if only he'd known. He couldn't have made Felix leave Elizabeth. He couldn't have made Mum look after the baby. So what's the point of going on about it now?
Well, did you tell him all that?
No. I just kept saying, let's forget it. But he would keep on. He shouldn't expect me to blame Mum. We were on our own together a long time before he turned up.
Fathers are like that, even stepfathers. They like to control everything. If my mother did anything behind my father's back...
Do you think I ought to write and warn Felix?
Oh, I expect he'd be grateful.
Yeah, but he can't avoid Richard forever, can he? Oh, I'm not sure I can be bothered anyway. Richard might have got over it by the time Felix gets back.
Perhaps you want them to have a row. Go and fight at the OK Corral, huh?
No, not really. It just feels very remote somehow.
Early and worked late, Richard, but I didn't realise you actually lived here.
Oh, I'm sorry, I should have told you.
I was sort of joking, but I see you're not. Whatever's happened? Can't you talk to me about it? I've been really worried about you the past week. You seem to be heading for some sort of breakdown.
So you're coming early to catch me at it.
I just wanted a private chat with you. Look, I know we've had our differences in the past, but I hope we can respect each other as colleagues. You can't work properly if you have a crisis in your private life.
I wonder some of our clients find it difficult to hold down a job. Their lives are one long crisis.
Look, could we focus on you for a minute? If you could tell me what's happened, I might be able to help you. I used to do marriage guidance. And I've been divorced myself.
Really? I had no idea.
Yes, it's a second marriage for both of us, Brian and me. Look, I know you think I'm some sort of dried-up old stick. But I might understand something of what you're going through.
You seem very sure this has got something to do with my marriage.
Well, I hardly think you'd be sleeping at the office if things weren't a great deal more uncomfortable at home.
Yes, of course. I'm being very stupid. I haven't had much sleep this week. Yes, I have had a row with Helen. That seems like a vast understatement. I've actually left Helen and I'm here because I've got nowhere else to go. I've also had a row with my stepdaughter and now I've got to wait until my so-called best friend gets back from holiday so that I can have a monumental row with him. Somehow I've got to hang on to my sanity while I wait.
Would you like to tell me what these people have done to make you so angry?
No, not really.
It's a question of adultery. There's a lot of worse things can happen to a marriage than that.
We're not talking about adultery. In fact, I'd rather wish we were. Mere adultery would be much easier to cope with. Bit of good honest lust on one side, bit of hurt pride on the other. My God, I must be grateful if it was as simple as that. Now, I am talking about the kind of deceit and betrayal you can't even begin to understand. Every morning when I wake up on that floor and my bones aching, I have to remember that the three people I loved and trusted most in the world have done this incredibly ugly thing.
Never seen you like this before.
No? Well, let me assure you, it's much worse from the inside.
But, Richard, we do have a spare room which you'd be very welcome to use.
Arion, you're amazing. You really do surprise me. You're very kind.
Let it out.
No, that's just what I mustn't do. It's only the anger that's holding me together. And I've got to hang on for another week.
So that when it just in time to see the blow about to fall. It was already too late.
Poor old Tony Blythe.
It was about time, but I left it just slightly ambiguous, so if I have to revive him, God forbid, I can.
So it was the lovely grandma who had asked him all the time. So. Poor Tony. I shall miss him. I feel quite sad.
I know. I just feel an enormous sense of relief. At last I've got rid of the tiresome little bugger.
Rest in peace, Tony Blythe.
Gone to the great investigation bureau in the sky. Good riddance, is what I say.
It's fantastic. You finished on time.
I told you all I needed was sunshine and you with your blue pencil. God, I feel wonderful. How long before this euphoria wears off?
About 2 days.
Yeah. And it's back to real books. I've got an idea for the new one, actually.
Already?
It's about a man who's having a midlife crisis. Has an affair with a girl he meets in the supermarket. He's trying to recapture his lost youth. But really, he loves his wife.
So what happens?
The girl leaves him for a younger man. But his wife won't have him back. So he, kills himself. It's a cautionary tale, a new grim message for the 90s to go with age. I've dealt with the gays, so I'll deal with the straights. You reap what you sow and all that stuff. Why should anyone get away with mere adultery?
Except that they do. All the time.
Anna Karenina didn't, nor did Madame Bovary. It's good enough for me.
They were women. They were stupid enough to take it seriously.
So was my hero. Can't get much more serious than suicide. I'm sensitive. A new man.
Don't tell me anymore.
Why not?
Well, you may not want to write it.
You know me so well. What's the matter?
I don't want to go home. It's been so perfect. I like having you all to myself.
Same terms as last time.
Yeah. Marion let me in.
And she can let you out again. I've got work to do.
And she said she'd take your course. I've got to talk to you. You hang up when I ring you. I don't know where you're living. You look terrible. I'm worried about you. I miss you.
I found that hard to believe. But I thought you were so used to acting independently, you'd hardly notice I'd gone.
Oh, God, you're going to be so pompous.
Then you're better off without me, aren't you?
Inga came to see me. I think she wanted to gloat. God, she was weird. High as a kite. All right. I did something serious without telling you, and I'm sorry.
Sorry you did it, or sorry I found out?
I just can't believe it. It cancels out the last 10 years.
Try harder.
You wish I told you, but what if I had? Abortion is out. Adoption's out, so what do we do? Bring up Felix's child? Have Felix drop round to pat it on the head? Have Elizabeth as a sort of an auntie, have Sally playing at motherhood in the long back. Make up some tale about a missing boyfriend. You tell me, Richard, what would you have done?
I wouldn't have forced my daughter to kill her own baby.
If Sally had really wanted to have that baby, she could have told you she was pregnant.
Sally does whatever you tell her. We both know that.
She came to me for help, and I helped her.
You made her have an abortion because you hate Felix, and bringing up a baby might have stopped you doing a few paintings. Sally's baby or my baby. Nothing must be allowed to get in the way of your work.
So that's what this is about.
You've never forgiven me for not getting pregnant by you. This isn't about Sally at all.
This is about all of us. God, don't you understand anything?
How can you and I be married if you go on behaving as if you're still single? No, not even that. As if you're still married to Carey. You can tell him what's happening, but you can't tell me.
Have you been talking to her?
Yes, of course.
You didn't upset her, did you?
I shouted a bit and made a fool of myself. She was in bed with that Indian boy at the time, so maybe she'll get pregnant again. Wouldn't surprise me if she does it just to rebel against you.
That is sick.
No, it makes perfect sense. You've got her so brainwashed. She probably chose Felix just to annoy you.
I don't want any more of your half-baked psychology.
Then get out of my office!
I just asked you to come home and all we do is have another row. Why is this all my fault? Isn't Felix to blame for anything?
I'm not married to him.
Well, you might as well be. Ever since I've known you, all I've heard about is how wonderful Felix is. Such a romantic person, such a free spirit. Screwing everything that moves and making his wife put up with it. Isn't he clever? Isn't he lucky? Doing everything that maybe you wish you could, but you haven't had the guts. And now this happens and it's all my fault. Well, just to try thinking that maybe some of it is his fault and maybe some of it is your fault. Bringing him into my home.
Yes. It is your home, isn't it? I left my wife and children for you. I wanted to have a child with you. I thought of Sally as my own daughter, but really all these years I've been nothing but a lodger. Not even a very good lodger. I couldn't pay enough rent. Thinking you wanted to say how well he taught you.
It mustn't be Jess.
I'm afraid I'm falling in love with you.
You know, every time we go away, I look forward to mountains of mail. In fact, you might almost say it's a reason for going, just to get lots of letters in one day.
And amongst them, there will be...
a summons from Hollywood. Come and write scripts for us, name your price, sell your soul for a fistful of dollars. God, what a bargain that would be.
And this time?
Guess they missed the post again. All I've got is a stack of bills. Plus, an invitation to talk to a writer's circle on how to write a thriller, as if I knew, and if I did, why should I tell them? An American student begging for help on her PhD thesis on crime writing? She might be pretty. Card from the library that my compact discs are 3 months overdue.
You're in good form this morning.
Oh, Lizzie, I keep forgetting that I have the pure rapture of remembering I've actually finished the book. That bastard Tony Blyde has gone forever. I'm a free man. It's yo-ho-ho, and eyes down, looking for the great novel again. We can make our fortunes or we can grow old in romantic poverty. What do you say, double or quits?
I love you.
Just as well.
That's quite a colour.
We do our best, slaving over a hot typewriter in the broiling sun. There's no limit to the sacrifices this man will make for his art. I'll have a dry martini, please. Are you still knocking back the Perrier? Is that the best you can do on 10% of me?
Well, I got used to it on that diet.
The thinnest agent in London gave me women about me that are fat. You're decently voluptuous, anyway.
No need to ask.
Finished.
Hello, Helen. How are you? It's Elizabeth. Are you all right?
Maybe this time we can have an auction.
Why not? Have some fun.
I'd like to see how much I'm worth.
But you don't really want to move.
No, but it wouldn't hurt to frighten them a little. This could be the big one.
It might be worth moving in the States. They haven't promoted you too well lately, and you could do with a hard sell. If they think they're getting another heartbreak
well,
merchant...
Well, bigger than that.
How long will you need?
Well, it's been cooking for some time. The first draft in, say, 6 months, and the final version maybe before Christmas, if I'm lucky, with a following wind.
That'd be great. They could come out by next autumn. Do you have a title? Or is that still under wraps?
I'm not sure yet. At first I thought... And then there was Lisa. Now that seems a bit soft now, thinking more. Anatomy of a love affair.
Should I have interrupted something important?
Rubbish. I'm just catching up after the holiday.
Oh, yes. Was it wonderful?
Yes, it was. Felix is always blissful on the holiday. Food and wine, sun and sex, work and talk, all the things he likes best. And I get him all to myself. It was a real treat. They're very brown. Yes, I don't believe all this stuff about skin cancer. It's like dieting. Doctors trying to take away our few remaining pleasures. Are you all right? You sounded very odd on the phone.
Richard has left me. It's true. I know, we were the perfect couple, right?
God, what a shock.
Yes. I do wish I hadn't given up smoking.
Do you want a drink?
Yes, please.
Is white wine all right?
Yes, wine, meth, terps, anything. Sorry, I can't tell you. We just had a monumental row, that's all, and he walked out.
Hello.
How's the holiday?
Oh, Richard. This is terrific. I finished the book. Oh, yeah. Feel great. I used to well when I wake up, have my snout in the trough with Natasha at lunchtime and what with that and the jet lag.
Yeah, I was thinking I might call in for a drink on my way home.
Yeah, why not? We could celebrate. What sort of time?
Yeah, well, I'm not sure when I'll be finished here.
Oh, no matter. I'm not going to be hurried to get home. It's quite nice to have some time on my own for a change.
Okay. See you later. Bye.
Bye.
If you'd only tell me what's happened.
Look, I just did something unforgivable, that's all, and he won't forgive me.
It's been good to see you. Good to talk. Do you know where he's living or anything? I never thought this would happen. I didn't. I could miss him so much. I used to be good at living alone, but I suppose it really wasn't alone, was it? I was with Sally. Have you been having an affair?
No, nothing like that.
My imagination's working overtime. I can only think you've had an abortion or been sterilized or both. Richard's always wanted more children.
No, please stop guessing. It's very embarrassing.
Sorry. I just can't help being curious, and I thought maybe I could help if I knew a bit more.
Nobody can help. The details are not important, but they are very personal. Look, I took a decision without consulting Richard, and I think I was right, and he thinks I was wrong, and that's all there is to it.
But he'll come round. He must. He'll have to forgive you eventually.
Really? That's what I keep telling myself, but I wonder. I mean, I'm seeing another side of him now. Well, maybe I always knew it was there, and that's why I didn't tell him the truth. It's not easy living with good people. They are implacable.
I wouldn't know. Felix is pretty easygoing. So long as he gets his own way, I mean. He's self-indulgent, but he indulges me too.
I never thought I'd envy you, but right now I do. Yes, going home to someone who'll never condemn you, never leave you, no matter what you do, because he hasn't got a leg to stand on. That must be very nice, very comfortable.
Well, I wouldn't put it quite like that. We do love each other.
I'm sorry. I'm not getting any sleep, and things just come out. I'm not thinking straight. Please don't hold that against me.
should stay to supper. I bet you're not eating properly.
No. I'd rather be alone, honestly.
Does Sally know about this?
Well, I didn't tell her anything, but Richard did. And she's rung to say she's sorry. What else can she do?
I thought maybe she could come home at weekends just to be with you.
No, I wouldn't expect that. She's got her own life to lead anyway. She's coming home for the vac in a couple of days.
Maybe Richard will be back by then.
Yes, that's what she says. She's like you. She thinks he'll come back.
But you don't.
No, I don't. I just have a feeling of doom. But I'd love to be wrong. Well, I really am going this time. Elizabeth, would you do me a favour? Please don't mention any of this to Felix. I rather you heard it from Richard.
Don't bother pretending you don't know what this is about.
Jesus, that really hurt.
I'd like to kill you.
God, I hope you won't.
The way we're friends. I trusted you.
Just calm down, Richard. I'd like to know exactly what we're talking about.
God, you're unbelievable. Even now you're trying to riddle out of it. You're wondering how much do I know. Well, everything, that's how much.
I told you.
Inga? Yeah, she went through your desk. She found a letter from Sally. You're doing it again. I can see with that shifty look in your face. Now you're wondering which letter. Is it only the affair, or do I know about the abortion as well? I can see by your face. Even at this stage, you lie to me if you felt you could get away with it.
Oh, there's no point asking for trouble. Look, I'm really very sorry. The whole thing should never have happened, and I take full responsibility. What more can I say? Look, let's have a drink and discuss this rationally.
You can't imagine that I'd drink with you.
Oh, I need one. Richard, we've been friends for 20 years. You know what I'm like. I'm not a plaster saint. I like having affairs. I've never pretended otherwise. Now, I know I should have left Sally alone, but she had a sort of crush on me, and I was tempted. But she made it easy for me. Well, irresistible, really.
If you're trying to blame
Sally. No, of course not. I'm just trying to explain how it happened. She'd made a start with some boy at school and knew there had to be more to it than that, and there I was. Now, I know what to say, don't shit on your own doorstep, don't foul the nest and all that, but I'm easily tempted. I was flattered. She's very beautiful.
She was 18 years old, for God's sake.
She made me feel young again.
Yeah. And she paid a high price.
Oh. Yes, that was rotten luck. She told me it was safe. I mean, it's not as if I took a chance on purpose. I'm not that irresponsible. I know it should have been belt and braces. I know that, really. It's happened to me a couple of times before, and I should have known better. But people make mistakes or forget or whatever.
She could have died.
Oh, come on. Abortion's actually safer than having a baby for obvious reasons, done properly, I mean.
Did you ever think of letting her have it?
Well, I never thought of leaving Elizabeth, if that's what you mean.
I mean, did you ever make Sally feel that she had a choice?
I felt that was very much her decision, hers and Helen's.
Not mine. None of you thought that I had a right to know.
Well, I thought it was up to them if they'd wanted to tell you. Or not. I've never wanted children, so I didn't think that I should interfere.
Did you offer to help financially?
I paid for the abortion, of course.
I mean child support.
I can't remember. I don't think so. I would have done if she'd have wanted it, but I was rather hoping she wouldn't because of upsetting Elizabeth.
I hope you rot in hell.
Expect I will. There is a hell.
Well, there is for people like you. There aren't the words for what I think of you.
I'm getting the message. Do you think you're overreacting? Just a touch.
wasn't all gloom and doom, you know. We had a nice time. We fell in love. It wasn't just mindless screwing. When I say I like having affairs, I mean just that. Not just the sex, but the chat, the presence, the secrecy, the whole package. It's a magic time for both of us. Not just for me. Both of us. We were happy. And that's all that matters. I think it's important, yeah. My parents named me well. Would you ever have told me if I hadn't found out? Of course not. Whatever for? I told you about Inger and you had mixed feelings about that. I'm just sorry it ended in tears, that's all. You've been getting off on my adventures for years, only this one came too close to home. Okay, point taken. I'm very sorry. It won't happen again. You don't seem to understand. This so-called friendship is over. You've ruined my marriage, and you may have ruined Sally's life. It'd be absurd. If I didn't know you better, I'd think you were jealous. You probably fancy Sally yourself. You've only done what you wanted to do.